which all of us know is about handwriting traits of superhero employee. So our forum was started in 2010 to create a platform to facilitate the act of giving back to the HR fraternity. During this unexpected period of COVID-19 lockdown and uncertainties, one of the founder members, Dr. Harish Chaturvedi, who's here with us, he decided to make a breakthrough endeavor of having industry stalwarts come to the forum and talk with us and help us get hope and perception to see the silver lining. HR Milestone as a forum envisions itself as a leading HR forum, which aims at learning and development of HR fraternity as a whole and through it the organization. Because human resource is not just limited to a department, it permeates through the entire organization, as at every step we deal with humans, maybe clients, vendors, employees, etc. Now, how do we do that? Our logo very well explains that. We have three initiatives. First initiative is HR Kitli, which is held every second Sunday of the month. And the objective is to make the understanding of human resource so simple that it can be discussed over a cup of tea at Chai Ki Kitli. And that is evident from the H in our logo, wherein we can see two people shaking hands. The other initiative is Let's Say Dil Se, which is downloading the knowledge. So we have stalwarts of industry like you, sir, sharing their experiences, knowledge and insights with us and helping us all enhance ourselves and grow personally and professionally. This is evident from the downloading arrow which we see in the H. And the third one is Corporate Wonderland. Here the industry experts, they share their knowledge and experience with the fresh graduates who enter the corporate world, so that the corporate jungle seems to be corporate wonderland for them. So this is shown in the necktie symbol that is there in H from H, in the HR Milestone logo. Talking about our presence, sir, we're present on all the social media platforms, maybe Facebook, Insta, LinkedIn, Twitter, Telegram, WhatsApp, YouTube. And we have more than 3,200 members pan-India who are associated with us. This was about HR Milestone, sir. And now I would like to talk about our speaker, our eminent speaker of the day, Mr. Sudhir Tove, who's also known as the Logo Guru. He is a graphologist, a symbologist, and a life transformer. While I was at school, my teachers and my parents used to tell me that make sure your handwritings are neat and clean. So I never understood what is there in handwriting. I mean, you just need to write down and give it to the teacher. It's her job to understand, read, and interpret, and do what she wants to do with it. And at times, my handwriting used to be so horrible, I myself couldn't interpret them after a few days. And I heard Gandhiji talk, regretting about having bad handwriting. So I did not understand why is handwriting so important. But while I was going through Sudhir sir's introduction, I found out that it can lead towards identifying the psychological state of a person while writing. It can also help understand and evaluate the personality characteristics. This was just amazing. I didn't know that handwriting would be such amazing and can get such amazing results. He is the first scientific logo designer and he has authored two books, Science of Manifestation and The Million Dollar Logo. He's also a symbologist. If I talk about his struggle, they surely give us goosebumps. Born in a lower middle class family where parents are rope construction workers, there's no one in the family who is an influential or an entrepreneur. He's a live example who's someone earning 50K per month and has turned his income from 50K per month to 50 lakhs per month of turnover. He did not know what his life's purpose is. But now he knows that of transforming 10 million lives by inspiring them to use the power of subconscious mind to manifest money, fame, success. Subconscious mind, as we all know, forms 90% of a total mind. He also intends to use symbology to end the struggles of life and help people to lead a balanced life, balance between good health, wealth, and relationships. He has done his graduation into engineering from Mumbai. That was about his educational background. Over to you, sir. Welcome once again to HR Milestone Forum.
Thank you very much for this brief introduction, Aditi, and thank you, Harishji, for giving me this opportunity to to talk on this forum. So it's like I don't have to introduce myself because you have covered all the aspect of what I do. About my book, it's available on Kindle right now. So you can go and have a look at it. This is the book name is Million Dollar Logo. Okay, so before, let me make you aware what we are going to have as a... So what will happen at the end of this webinar? At the end of this webinar, you would be knowing about the impact of signature and handwriting on your personality, and you would be it's like you next 120 minutes you're going to dive deep into the subconscious mind's realm, and you are going to discover the secrets how exactly it impacts your life, your own persona and your work culture, everything. It's like next 120 minutes a different world will be in front of you. So are you guys ready and excited? Comment below if
yes, sir.
Yeah, awesome. Great. Now let's start with this. No, let's understand what the. Okay, so the people who are there, they are going to get a special gift from me at the end of this webinar. So be ready, be aware, and be focused. And before we go forward, I would like you all to give a close attention, a complete attention to this particular webinar. So close your mobile phones, switch off them. If you have social media, which is buzzing you all the time, close it out as well. And take pen and paper ready. Get it ready. Start taking the notes. And if possible, okay, this is the book which I was talking about. If possible, keep your videos on so that I get this feeling of talking to a live audience, because already we are losing out on energy. A lot of energy is being wasted over here because of the non-physical interaction. So if you can just switch on your videos, it will be great for me to talk, you know, because I will have that feeling. So now, how many of you have heard this word graphology before this webinar? How many? You can type in as well, you know, I can see. Have you heard, or this is the first time you are listening to this? Okay, something called as a graphology. Okay. Yes. Harini says yes. Okay, so great. So few are there who are aware about this. So first time. Good. Hell. Elibert saying first time. Rishi Agrawal saying yes. Great. Neha, yes. Awesome. So now, for those who are listening to this for the first time, let me give you a bookish definition of graphology. Now, what is graphology? Graphology is the science of understanding human subconscious mind through handwriting. So it's a very technical definition. If I want to make it simple and, you know, it's basic in terms of understanding, so the definition would be like, you know, your handwriting, your signature reveals your personality, your mindset. So how exactly a handwriting is able to do it? So when you think, you know, if I ask you this question, how many of you think that you are thinking from brain? How many of you are there who think that they are thinking from brain? Just write brain if you think that you are thinking from brain. Just type in brain if you think that you think from brain. How many of you have a brain for that matter? Okay. So brain, and some of you will be thinking from mind. Some of you are feeling that, okay, I have a brain, I have a mind. So now this mind thinks. If I want to differentiate between brain and mind, what is brain and what is mind? So brain is basically a hardware. Brain is a hardware and the mind is software. So after your limbs, these are your limbs. After your limbs, the maximum space in your brain is allocated to your fingers. So the moment you think, this thinking goes into the brain. And the brain generates an electromechanical signal. Those signals then travel from your hand to the finger, and then your finger moves on the paper. It forms line, loop, and curve. So this line, loop, and curve are known as the graphs. And the analysis of this is known as the graphology. So because it is a writing, it is psycho-neuromuscular activity. It involves your mind, it involves your brain and it also involves your muscles. That is why when you write, it reveals so many things about you. So there are three levels of action which happens in your body. First is a reflex action. How many of you are aware about the reflex action? Awesome. Aditi is aware. So what is reflex action? If I want to ask you this question, what is the reflex action according to you? What happens in reflex action?
Before the signal goes to the brain, immediately from the spine, there is immediate reaction to it.
Correct. Without you knowing, without you being aware, without you being conscious about what is happening, it happens. If you touch a hot pan, immediately your hand goes like this. Yeah, immediate reaction. Neha is saying, yeah, immediate reaction. Now, how are you able to do it without thinking? Because your body knows it. Your body is there. Your DNA has this information stored from so many thousands and millions of years in your body. That DNA knows everything about the world, because it is there from so many years. So now you just cannot control this action. This is a reflex action. Now, if you want to be very great in doing something, what you need to do? You need to repeat it over and over again and again, so that this thing of yours, this habit of yours, becomes the part of your reflex action. See, if you imagine a Tendulkar playing a ball of Shoaib Akhtar, 150 km per hour, the ball is jumping on him like a racer bullet train, and he's able to hit it for six. How it is possible? It is possible because Tendulkar has practiced this so much time, so many times, that first, it was a conscious action. Second, it was the involuntary action. And third, it becomes a reflex action. So reflex action is something which you don't have any control on. That is why his inning of 241, where he was not playing a cover drive, was regarded as one of the best. Why? Because he was able to curb his reflex action. So now there is second level of action is voluntary action. Voluntary action is something, you know, you just choose. Okay, let me do this. So you choose to drink a water. So while drinking water, you drink like this. Some people drink like this. Or let's assume you choose to walk. So when you walk, you are walking like this. If you walk, if you see Sanjay does walk like this. You know, his back is bent. So what it indicates? This indicates that the Sanjay Dutt is feeling a weight of something on his body. And because he is not able to, you know, cope up with that weight, he bends his back. So this is a subconscious level of action, bending the back. Walking is a conscious action. But the moment he bends the back, it is happening subconsciously. Subconscious is feeling the weight of expectation from his father on his body. So that is why he is bending. So this is now the writing A is a conscious action. We want to write A, this is a conscious action. But the way A comes out on the paper, it is a subconscious action. You don't have any control over it. So writing some sentence is a conscious action. But the way the sentence comes out on the paper is a subconscious action. It is an involuntary action on which you don't have any control. So this is why the graphology is so powerful. This is why you cannot hide anything from graphologists, because these involuntary actions are always there in your writing. Okay. So now let's understand this concept from a video wherein how exactly it happens, how exactly it comes onto the paper. So I will just share again, because I think the video has to be, sound has to be on. Okay, just watch the video, you will understand. Oh, So this was about how your mind reveals things about you. Okay. Now, see, this particular session has to be interactive. And you know, the more I come, more I know that you guys are involved, more I see your reactions, your comments, more I get enthusiasm. My energy becomes up for speaking. Okay. So now we will not go much into the presentations, because you guys are corporate guys. You might have seen thousands of presentations before this. So I'm going to ask you this question: why you behave the way you behave? You know, why you do the things in certain way all the time? What is the reason behind it? You talk in a certain way, you know, you do the things in particular way. So why you do this in the way you do? Yeah. Yes, Aditi.
So because our brain is already programmed, and there is a channel through which we work. There's already a programming which is done, and that is very much automatic. So we get driven into that, and then automatic channel, it starts.
Nice. You used a very good word. I want other people also to answer. Yes. Excuse me. Why you behave the way you behave?
Sir, there are even answers in the chat boxes. Would you like me to?
Yeah. I'm watching it. You know, Neha is seeing. Yeah. Okay. I can see that. Immediate reaction, subconsciously, that I can see that.
Okay.
Why you behave the way you behave all the time? What is the reason? You behave in particular way all the time, right? So I want someone else also to answer.
Past experience.
Amazing. Who is that?
Back of the mind, they are training. Small mind, back of the mind, there is something, some experience on that base we are behaving.
Yes, very nice, Ashok ji, very nice, Ashok Kar. Very good. So, Aditi used the word programming. Ashok is saying past experiences. So, what is programming basically? When you get born on this earth, you are born as naked. Nobody comes in the suit and tie and boot, you know, everybody is naked. It means it is clean slate. There is nothing in your mind. You are empty. So between 0 to 14 years of age, you get programmed. Yeah, upbringing, right? You get programmed. You get programmed by what? You get programmed by male and female. You get programmed by 0 and 1. The way computer is getting programmed with the 0 and 1. Computer gets programmed with the binary language. 0 means current, no current. 1 means current. Similarly, you guys also get programmed by 0 and 1. And in your case, what is 0? The 0 means the things which you cannot see. They don't exist, but they have a lot of impact on your life. So if I want to ask you this question, which are those things who have a lot of impact on your life, but you cannot see them? Which are those things? Just type in the chat box. Which are those things according to you? Which has a lot of impact on your life, but you cannot see them? Think, what will that? Yes, Neha, right, very nice. Correct. Emotions, feelings, love, desires, dreams. You cannot live without them, and you cannot see them, but they have a large impact on your life. Now, the things like taking action, you know, jumping at, these are called as ones. The things which you cannot see are called as zeros. The zeros are emotions. And the significance, the thing which shows emotions is nothing but your mother. Mother is a symbolism of emotion. So you get programmed by zeros between 0 to 7 years of your age. That is why a kid in kindergarten, the kid in nursery is not supposed to be taught by a male. Any male is not able to handle that kid at all. The reason is, between 0 to 7 years of age, the kid only responds to emotions. That is why you all have a ladies teaching to nursery and kindergarten kids. So between 0 to 7, you get predominantly programmed by zeros. And between 7 to 14, you get predominantly programmed by the ones. When I talk ones is nothing but a male. Your mom, your brother, big brother, your father, your uncle, your math teacher, PT teacher, sports teacher. You know, all these things are male. So when I say all these things, they are father figure. Your mother and mother figure. And from 7 to 14 years of age, you get programmed by father and father figure. So between 0 to 14 years of age, 7 to 14 is a crucial period for your physical growth, because this particular phase is about your father all the time. If you are not getting enough support between 7 to 14 years of age, then what? Then you don't grow physically strong. Then you are not confident enough. Then you don't take a lot of action. So these things then, you know, reduce your power, reduce your ability to take action in life. So it's very, very necessary for an individual to have a father's backing, father's support, father's presence in his life from 7 to 14 years of age. And what happens? And during that only phase, our father is in middle age crisis. And that is why a lot of us, especially in India, because in India, it's so difficult to become, to have livelihood all the time, comfortable livelihood. So father is always busy, and that is where the father is not giving attention to the kid. And that is why a lot of Indian males have been influenced by females, in the sense their mom, they have a lot of influence of their mom. That is why we guys are good in softwares. Why? Because software is a feminine thing. And since we are so much influenced by the females in our life, that we value more emotions. That's why our more movies, the movies which we make, are more of on emotional side. That's why we value the art. That's why we value the writings. No, these all things is because our father was always busy working. And that's why we have less influence of, that's why we are good in cricket. Because in cricket, you get time to think. That's why we are good in chess. Why? Because you get time to think. But we are not good with the football. Why? Because we are not good with the rugby. Why? Because it requires a lot of action. It is a male dominant sport. If you go to Germany called their land as a fatherland. If you are in India, you call it as a motherland. So when you call a motherland, you are influenced by mother. That is why you have small roads in India. But if you go to Germany, you will see big roads. They talk about father. They are action-oriented people. That's why when you design a car, the first thing which you design is a toolkit. But when Germans design a car, they say, this doesn't require a toolkit. This doesn't have Stepney, you know. So one of my friends is not buying a BMW because they don't have Stepney. You know? So what I'm trying to say is, this is what we are. And this is now, since the English has come into the picture, we have changed. Because now English has, if you see our own writing, the way we write, what happens with way that we, our Devanagari script doesn't have the thing which is called as lower zone. If I want to make you about the zones, you know, I will just, before we start, let me make you aware about the zones. Okay. So now, if I draw this kind of human, so I will divide this human into three parts. This is called the upper zone, middle zone, and lower zone. So this will be upper zone. This will be middle zone. And this will be lower zone. So if you see our writing has what? If I write Ray, it will be like this. So our writing will always have the upper zone and middle zone. Now this upper zone, as you can see in the picture as well, upper zone is related to this. This is related to your vision, intelligence, everything. Whereas if I talk about this is middle zone. Middle zone is all about talking, talking, eating, whatever organs you have in your this particular part, this part of organs are related to your daily functionality. What you do on daily basis is what this particular portion shows. So this is all about how you are living the life on daily basis. So middle zone is all about talking, eating, dressing up, you know, whatever you wear mostly are on this side, on stomach, on your chest. You want to showcase your jewelry, your good clothes on this particular portion most of the time, because this is a show. This is a show. This is the upper zone is about the future. So middle zone is all about the present. eating. So that is why the scripts which are dominantly in the middle zone, the script like Gujarati script is a dominant middle zone. Few years back, I was traveling from Nagpur to Pune. I was taking a train, and the entire compartment was having Gujaratis and a few Maharashtrian and Gujaratis. Nothing against Gujaratis. I am just explaining the way it happens. So the train started, and then there was a sound of eating. They offered me a lot of sweets, a lot of things, and then that sound was eating was there till the train reached to the Pune. So the eating is again a middle zone activity. And they were chatting and they were eating. A Gujarati is a middle zone, dominant middle zone heritage. So what happens in terms of Gujarati? Gujarati are fond of foods. They will eat a lot of variety. And for a simple paan to eat, they can travel 10 kilometers to do it. So all these things are the middle zone activities. They like to talk, they like to gupshup. That is why middle zone is all about quick, fast, present. No? That is why they will be more interested in doing the transaction which are quick. So they will say, ki, 2% kam de boss, but abhi ke abhi paisa abhi. No, they want things very fast. It's all about middle zone. So in our scripture, our own scripts, the only two things were present in the middle zone and the low and the upper zone. But if you talk about the low zone, we have very, very small lower zone like this. Not a big lower zone all the time. So we guys, now lower zone is about action. This particular portion is all about action. This shows you as an action-oriented person. This shows you as the person who take sports, sex, money. All those things are shown by this particular zone. So now what happens? Since we are not great in terms of the mindset about the ideas, so what happens that we will always be fascinated about talking about the idea. So we had these battles, Panditya dikhana hai. Two pandit will come, Raja will sit and people will talk, king will sit and people will talk about how the scriptures are great. Everybody will show their panditya because we have upper zone and because we have our middle zone. There is nothing called as lower zone. So people learn from us, went to US, went to Western countries and they implemented. So whatever you see, the talk about law of attraction, the talk about meditation, and whatever is there in the West regarding the spirituality, regarding the subconscious mind, regarding the way you influence the mind, all knowledge has come from whom? Us. But we are never great in terms of the implementation. We are always great in terms of thinking and speaking about it. So, and our all scripts have their own uniqueness. If you talk about the language called as Marathi, Maharashtrian scripts has a unique kind of twist. They have the words, very difficult words like tra. So because they have this kind of ability to twist the tongue, that's why the Maharashtrian batsmen are the best in the world. Why? Because the Maharashtrian batsmen are known for playing cheeky shots. Where there is no gap, they find a gap. And, it's smart because they have this ability to twist the tongue. If you compare Sidhu with the Gavaskar, Sidhu will always be known for hitting the sixes. He will hit the ball out of the park because all Punjabi batsmen, Yuvraj Singh, Sidhu, and many others, they have raw muscular power. So because their language is like that. So Maharashtrian language is like that. If you talk of Marwadi language is so flexible that if a Marwadi stays in a particular area for a longer period of time, it's like you cannot differentiate whether he's a local or a Marwadi because that much flexible they are because of their language. And that language is very, very good for business, a day-to-day business, a routine business, a traditional business. So if you want to be great in business, you need to learn Gujarati and Marwadi because both these languages have influence of business because both these languages are very, very middle zone oriented language. That's why Marwadis also are fond of a lot of food, different kind of food, sweets and many things. And same as Gujaratis because they talk about middle zone. And the more you are in middle zone, the more you are good as a businessman. You are good as a businessman when you live in middle zone. Because there you are not thinking about very long distant future, but you are thinking about right now, what am I supposed to do? Right now, how to handle this problem? So solving a problem on a day-to-day basis is more important for you when you talk about the medal zone. So this is about the way we have been influenced up till now. If you observe, India has have progressed a lot in terms of the infrastructure after the introduction of English to the culture. Because English language will add infrastructure all the time. Whereas we will always add value. We will always talk about emotion. We will always talk about intelligence. So this was about the way we get programmed by what? We get programmed by zeros and ones. Now, so you got this idea of what is zero and what is one. So one is your father and father-like figures, and zero is your mother and mother-like mother figures. Okay, so you get programmed by zero and ones. Now, okay, up till now, any questions? If you have any questions up till now about whatever we have discussed. Because from here onwards, yeah.
Yeah, excellent presentation. Excellent. Very good.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now, let's understand some aspect of the handwriting. You know, what exactly happens in terms of handwriting. Okay, so now I'm going to share again my screen to make you aware. Now, when we talk about the handwriting, what happens? This is a page. Okay, I'm drawing a page. Now, this page has two sides. This is left, this is right. Okay, this is left and this is right. If you're not speaking, kindly keep yourself on mute. Okay, so now left and right. Now, left side, if you look at your own body. How many of you have seen the photo of Ardhanarishwar? How many of you seen? If you have not seen, I will show you after this particular discussion of the topic. But how many of you seen the Ardhanarishwar photo? Okay, very nice. Neha has seen, Sudhanshu has seen, Ruchi has seen. Awesome. So if you observe, what happens in terms of, wow, lot of people you have seen. If you observe the Ardhanarishwar photo, what you see that you have the female on the right side. The Devi is on the right side. Parvati is on the left side. So left side will always indicate the Parvati. Okay. And the right side of that photo is about the Shankar, about the Shiva. So what is left basically? In your life, the first time you got when you got birth on this earth, the first thing which your mother provided you was security. Your mother carried you in her womb. You know, you're there protected into multiple layers of fat and everything else. She nourished you, she protected you. So that is why the left side is indicated by what? It is indicated by the security. So the one thing which your left side will indicate always is about a security. And what all things in your life gives you security? In your life, the things like parents, past, country, religion, and society. These are the things which will always gives you a security. So the left side will indicate past, parent, country, religion, and society. Whereas on the right side is what? If this is the security, then this will be what? This will be risk. If this is the safety, this will be opportunity. If this is a past, this is a future. So the right side of the page will always indicate risk, opportunities, future, confidence, children, all those things we have on this side. So that is why when you see a script which travel from right to left, are you about the script which travel from right to left? Which are the script according to you which travels from right to left while writing? Urdu, right? Arabic, right? So these are the people, the more you write Urdu, more you speak Urdu, the moment Urdu becomes your national language, you will talk more about what? You will talk about the country, you will talk about the religion, you'll talk about the past. So that is why all these countries who have Urdu, who promote Urdu, who speaks Urdu a lot, will always talk about their past, will always talk about their country, will always talk about their religion. Whereas the person who will write from this in this way will always talk about what? This person will always talk about future, opportunities, risk, how to grow. So now we are going to divide this page into two parts. Now this is what the diagonal we draw. With this diagonal, this is top, this is bottom, and this is the right margin. So with this diagonal, what happens? This side will be for whatever we discussed up till now, risk, opportunities, future, children, everything. And these two will always be about past, parent, country, religion, and society. But this top has a different significance as well. Now, left side will always indicate the security, whereas top thing of the page will always indicate about how are you treating a left side thing. So the top will show, the left will show the care, whereas the top will show your respect. If I ask you this thing, what do you do when the national anthem is going on? What do? If you happen to listen to the national anthem, what do you do? You stand up, and what do you do? What do you do after that? You stand up, and then what? You start singing? Okay. What if you go to somebody's cremation? If you happen, you stop moving. You stand up and you stop moving. Yeah. You show respect. Yeah, very true. You show respect. What if you go to somebody's cremation? What do you do over there? You know, you just have white clothes, you go there, and what do? If you see a dead body, you know, having this puja and everything over there, you go and sit next to the dead body, and what do? You don't do anything. You do nothing. So when you do nothing, it's like you are giving. Yeah, you don't move, you don't do anything. When you don't do anything, what it means? This page is nothing but the 24 hours. This is the possibility. Everybody gets 24 hours in their life. You know? Whether you are Ambani, Bill Gates, or a normal human being, nobody can get more than this, and nobody can, you know, buy, or nobody can steal this time from you. Everybody gets this thing as a common. So when you don't do anything, it's like you are giving an empty space. This is an empty space you are giving to that person. You are doing nothing. So when you do nothing, it means you are donating your time. And if you read our scriptures, donating time is the highest level of donation. So when you do nothing, it means that you are showing respect. If you see Chinese people do what? Whenever they see you, Chinese and Japanese people, they will bend their back and they will say, Namaste. So this bending of back creates an empty space between whatever space they were occupying. They empty it by bending the back. So that space is empty now. That space is no more occupied. So that shows the respect. When you drop your neck like this in front of somebody, it's like you are doing this thing as empty. So dropping of neck also shows respect. So the top side of the page will always show the respect. And if you talk about the bottom side, this bottom side shows about the execution, the way you occupy execution. That is why if you see a Chinese movies, old Chinese movies, touching the feet of elderly people, that is also respect, because you bend again to touch the feet. So now if you talk about the Chinese movies, old Chinese movies, what we will see? You will see a guy carrying a message into the king's palace. And that particular message is being read by the person like this. So Chinese used to write in this way, top to bottom. This was the old way of writing Chinese. So when you go like this, you will always be good about execution, because this particular side shows how good are you with the execution. What happens in terms of the Chinese people? They are extremely good at executing things. So you tell Chinese that this is the thing you want to get it done. They will say yes. And they might not take a leave, but they will complete the work for you. Okay, so this was about the page margins. No, now why am I talking about this page margin and anything else? Because if you want to have a good employee, you don't want an employee who wastes time. So you will always like to have an employee who will take the opportunity. The person who is occupying this portion, no? That person will be good at what? At taking the opportunity, taking the risk. And the person who will occupy this side will be good at taking the action. The person will be good at executing things. So if you ask a person to write 1.5 pages of writing, and if that person writes like this, that he's occupying the right margin. Or if that person is writing like this, that the person is occupying the bottom margin as well. It means what? This person is extremely efficient. This person takes a lot of risk. This person takes a lot of opportunities, and this person doesn't waste time. Now, the tricky part over this, because he is confident, but because this also shows confidence, because this is extremely good with the execution, it also means that there is a chance that this person might not stick to one organization for a longer time, because he's good. So if you're not taking care of him, he might leave you. Now, another thing which you might be wanting as a HR professional, as a person who is handling the manpower or the resources of the company, what you want is a person should have a respect and the care, respect and the care towards the rules and regulation of the organization. You don't want rule breaking people, troubling people in your organization. So if you have went to school, I hope you must have, all of you. So you must have written on the book, and that book might be having this kind of lines over this and red color, two lines. Now what red color is? Because red color shows danger, and this particular thing shows that this is the care you need to have towards the rules and regulation of society, and this much of respect you must have towards the rules and regulation and elderly people and other things in your society. So this is called a school left margin, 1/8 of the page. So if your employee is writing like this, no, if he's breaking the rules on blank paper, this is I'm showing on the this paper, but on blank paper, if you see an employee having, this is called as the VV left margin. If your employee is writing like this, this is called as VV left margin, then you should avoid this person, because this person has a rule breaking tendencies. If you're okay, if he's super talented, then you go for it. If not, then it's better not to have this kind of employees who do not follow the rules and regulation of the company. And if you combine this trait with this, if he is occupying the right margin, lower margin, and he has a rule breaking tendency, then what? Then he will not leave a single stone unturned for breaking the rules and regulation of society and your company. So this is a very dangerous combination. A person who is occupying entire margin on the right side and bottom margin, and the left margin is wavy. Now this is a dangerous combination as an employee. This person will do a lot of mischief, a lot of garbage, a lot of setting inside the organization. But this person is good when you are supposed to do illegal work. Let's assume your company is handling some kind of government contract wherein you have to do some kind of setting, whatever, then this is the person who can do it. So everybody has their uses, it's not like that. But if your company is ethical, very strong, simple, and you are always involved in ethical work, then you should not hire such kind of employees. But if you're known for doing unethical things, then go for it, because this is the right kind of person for you. So this was about the margin, right margin, left margin, top and bottom. Any questions up till now? We have learned, we have discovered about margin just now. Any questions? It's a big, big topic. I'm just trying to just squeeze and shorten it. Yes. Yeah, Neha, Eli, Bhavik. Thank you, Neha, for saying so. Any questions? You know, you must have some doubts. Okay, now, if you don't have any questions, let me also give you insight about when we spoke about, okay, what about the top place yet to be explained? Same as the left side? No, top place is for the respect. Left is for the care. Care for the left side things and care for the left side, respect for the left side. What happens when someone has big writings, occupies left and right both? Okay, if somebody is, this is the person, if somebody is writing like it is occupying all the margins, there is this, it is called as no margins left. So when you have no margins left, it means this person doesn't care about others' emotions and this person becomes workaholic. So if you have a project wherein you want some employee to be working full time 24/7, then you need to go for this kind of person who has no margins on the paper. Let me check if I have a sample to show. I will show you the sample as well. I'll just check. So this person, if you don't have any margin on any side, all margins occupied, this is the right kind of person for a project in which you need to work a lot. 24/7, if you are busy in the project, then wow, this is the dream employee for you. Okay, I have the sample. Let me share the screen. So now if you see in this particular sample, what you see is now this person has no margins on any side. No margins on any side. So this is a person, I hope you are able to see it. So I'll just narrow it down a bit. Okay, now this is a person is the right kind of employee if you want somebody to work 24/7. Now, since this person is non-emotional, this person is not giving importance to others' emotion and his own emotions as well, you know, he will be uncaring. But if you want somebody to work 24/7, right kind of person to hire. No margins. But he will not care about you. He will not care about your company. He will not care about anything else. He just wants to be busy. He just wants to be there. He just wants to be working all the time. Okay. So this is the margins. No margins. Any other question? Thank you very much for asking that question. Then, okay, would this person be logical and practical in his approach? Now, Neha, that comes from the different aspect. You know, there are a lot of aspects in the handwriting, like angles, slant, size, you know, spacing. So all those things will define whether this person will be logical or practical or not. But one thing is sure, this person will be busy in work all the time. 24/7, he will be thinking about the work, and work only. Okay, great. So this is the third thing which we just covered, the employee. This can be a superhero employee for you if you have that kind of a project. You know, this person will not like to enjoy things. Unko maza karne mein maza nahi aata unko. They are very focused about their work. Right. The next topic is about the size. Now, what is size basically? So for everyone, this blank page becomes 24 hours. This is one day. This is day. 24 hours. So the way you treat the day, the way you are going to handle your day is the size. Size is your announcement to the world that this is what I am, and this is how I'm going to tackle the challenges of the day. Because every day is a challenge for you, whether you want or not, do not want. For some people, getting their stomach clear in the morning is a challenge. So your day starts with the challenge. For some people, getting up and doing the exercise, getting up and doing the brush also can be a challenge for a lot of people. So every day is a challenge, small or big, doesn't matter. But the way you are going to approach to the challenges is the size. So if right now I would like all of you to write down 5 sentences. The first sentence is, I love this world. And while writing this, try to write it as big as possible, the biggest possible way of writing it for you. Write, I love this world. And then now, thoda sa bada likho, because now you need to reduce the size and write it again. I love this world. Now reduce the size again by 10-20% and write this, I love this world. And now again reduce the size and write again the same sentence, I love this world. And now again reduce the size and write as smallest possible handwriting and write, I love this world. Now when you do this, what happens? You must have observed a lot of people who would have started like writing, a lot of you would have started with this kind of style like this. Okay, but the moment you were reducing the size, you went into deep, and some people even went into the paper to write it, because the bigger the size, easier it is for you to write. The smaller the size, you need to concentrate more to write it. All of you got this experience, right? Just now while writing it. So what it shows that smaller the writing, the more focus is the person. Larger the writing, more result-oriented person is. If you go and talk to the person who has a large handwriting and ask what happened to the match yesterday, he will say we won. But whereas if you go and talk to the person who has a small handwriting size, this person will say, we lost the match. We won the match in the 46th over with 6 wickets to remain. And we also hit 15 sixes. So because this person is more interested in details. So the bigger handwriting size is the person who, the smaller handwriting size is a detail-oriented person. Bigger handwriting size is the person who is result-oriented. So if you want to promote somebody in a project which has a bigger budget, go for the person who has a bigger handwriting size. Whereas if you are executing a project wherein you need to look at the small details like any software programming and all, there, a person with a smaller handwriting size will be of more use, because he will go in details and check everything, every possible thing. So this handwriting size, bigger handwriting people will always be vocal. Those people show great leadership qualities as well. So bigger handwriting size are kind of show up kind of people. They talk a lot, they mingle with people a lot, they speak a lot. They buy expensive clothes. They are big spenders. They do not spend on petty things. They want to spend on big things. So, unka watch acha rehta hai, unka suit boot acha rehta hai. Everything is great in terms of the looks. Bigger handwriting shows, presentation. Yes, presentation also comes from a lot of different things. But bigger handwriting is basically show off. It also shows ego. Of course, writing has around writing size has around 12 types, different kind of handwriting. But we are just discussing about big and small handwriting size. Is the third personality more intimidating? Is their person? Yeah, because they will come a big way on you. This is like they are trying to post their mindset on you, or they will be like pressing you all the time. It's difficult to tackle these people. These people have a lot of ego.
Size of handwriting.
Medium
size of handwriting.
So medium size handwriting shows the characteristics of both. At times they are leader, at times they are follower. The small handwriting will always be follower. Big handwriting will always be leader. So medium size handwriting will, it's like they exhibit both the characteristics at times. So this is the right kind of handwriting. If you are not getting promoted in your job, is because of this characteristic, that you are good as a employee as well as a leader. So a lot of people who get early promotions in their life are having a big handwriting size, because they show that leadership quality again and again. Influencer, right? They can influence people. Okay. So what Sudhanshu is asking, what about those who write with different sizes, different time? It's like if your size is varying a lot, it means you are not a confident person. It's like you have shaky confidence, because handwriting, consistent handwriting size shows you are confident. if your size is varying a lot, chota bada bahut zyada ho raha hai, it's called as varying handwriting size, variable handwriting size. So these people are not confident. They have shaky confidence. Now success comes from a lot of different aspects, you know, because of, for example, Amitabh Bachchan has a big signature, you know, big handwriting. So he started something called as ABCL. He took a big initiative. He tried to do something which is unimaginable for a lot of people. But what happened? He was not able to perform it. So success depends on how much you know about that thing, how much you are confident about the thing, how much you are aware about that thing, and how much money you have, how much experience you have. So just taking initiative doesn't mean you will be very, very successful. You need to have passion, you need to have knowledge, you need to have skill, you need to have money to become successful in any particular area, along with the leadership qualities. Writing with small font, but yeah, this is in different.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes. Yeah, I'm listening. Hello? Yeah, somebody was asking some question. Great. Not an issue. So this is about the handwriting size.
Now, I was asking the question.
Okay.
That in this handwriting, nothing is right or wrong.
Yes.
The thing is that this shows your personality.
Yes.
You are fitting to which kind of area.
Correct.
Okay. And that is what is required. It is nothing like that. The small handwriting is a bad or big is a good. It is nothing like that. This shows your personality and your personality fitting to different kind of aspect.
Bingo.
That is what you should understand.
Yes.
Correct?
Yes. Yeah. There is nothing right. I am explaining you, nothing called as right and wrong. It depends on what is the circumstance. It's like knife.
Yeah.
So the way you are going to use the knife will decide whether knife is good or bad. If you're a public speaker, if you are somebody who wants to influence of the world, then smaller handwriting size will not suit you. But if you're a researcher, if you want to go and dig something deep, if you want to research in maybe in atomic bombs, then a smaller handwriting size will be more suitable for you. If you are a painter, a smaller handwriting size will be able to show smallest possible aspects of that painting in that as a paint, because you are a detail-oriented person. If you are if you are a banker who gives loan, so you need to have the personality of smaller handwriting size. Because you need to go into details to look for what exactly can be a problem in this particular case. So nothing is bad and good, as Jay Prakash said.
Yeah.
Nothing is bad and good. Everything is the way it is. And if
Adityanath must have the big handwriting.
I don't know that.
Yeah, the execution. The thing is that the way the things have been executed.
How to know the person?
It's just a joking part of,
How to know if a person is having a big handwriting size? First, look at his clothes. Are they expensive? Look at his watch. Look at his shoes. Are they expensive? Because these people would like to show off. These people like to spend in big way. So big handwriting people will always have a good car, good clothes. They want to have all the luxuries of life around them. Okay, so this was the fourth type of handwriting character, wherein you can know which employee is more suitable for which kind of job. Okay, now there is something called as zones, which we discussed. This is a limitation of graphology, that graphology does not treat any male and female differently. Why? Because in male there can be a female and in a female there can be a male. So I'm not talking about any because you get programmed by zeros and ones. So if between 0 to 14 years of age, if you have been more programmed by zeros, more programmed by your mom, your mother like figure, then you will have more of this kind of nature, feminine nature. And if you have been more programmed by ones, then you will have a lot of masculine nature. That's why you see men who are girlish in nature. Men who like to wear good clothes, do a natta patta and a lot of things, makeup and all. There are people who like that. And there is nothing wrong in that. They have been more programmed by zeros. they're well groomed. How many of you have seen the movie Satya Pe Satya? In Satya Pe Satya, all those people, yeah, great, thank you, Neha. So on Satya Pe Satya, all those people who used to live with Amitabh Bachchan, we are having a lot of male dominance. That's why they were unorganized. They were not clean. They used to, you know, if you go to any bachelor's room, a male bachelor's room, you will see all the clothes lying here and there, you know, all the nonsense. The utensils have been not washed for the last 15 days. The room is clean and not clean, dirty. Why? Because that is what the male is. Male doesn't know how to be groomed, how to be well groomed. You know, he will always be messy. He will always be lazy. And imagine the moment a Hema Malini enters in their life, what happens? Whoa, boom, everybody's organized, clean. So females, organization. Females, you know, so the males who have been more programmed by zeros will have this characteristic of being well-groomed, well-looking, good-looking. They will care about their hairstyle a lot. They will care about their clothes a lot. They will not be messy. They will be organized most of the time. And the ladies who have been programmed by ones are tomboy ladies. You know, they will ride bullet. They will, you know, they will talk rough language, raw language. They will do all sort of stuff which male are supposed to do. They will fight. They will also fight with the males. You know, they will. So tomboy. So graphology doesn't differentiate between you as a male and you as a female. It always talks about what your mind is. Is your mind is more feminine or is your mind is more masculine? See, all these actors who work in the movie are very, very feminine actors. That's why they understand the emotion. That's why they can emote the emotions. That's why they care about their looks. That's why they care about their hairstyle. You know, that's why they care about a lot of other things. Even the people who go to the gyms are very, very feminine in nature, because the male are supposed to have a straighter body and a female is supposed to have a curvier body. So they are more conscious about their curves, the people who go to the gyms a lot. So these people are more feminine in nature. That's why they watch themselves in mirror for so much long hours. Okay, so graphology will always talk about you being a male or you being female in your mind and not in your body. Okay, so that was the point about it will not be different for male and female. Now there are some questions of Prima Fisher Sudhanshu, you correct. Does big size font also mean that they might miss out? Yeah, detailing, yeah. They don't have attention on details. They just go into the market, order. See, if you compare this to big handwriting and small handwriting size, a small handwriting size person will go and only buy the things which he needs in the quantity which he has written. Whereas a person with the big handwriting size will go into the supermarket and buy extra stuff, unnecessary stuff, and he will not buy one thing. He will, if he want to buy a packet of one thing, he will buy 2 or 10 at times, you know. So he will be always a big spender and he will never check what is the detail. If you are a Kirana store guy, if you see a big handwriting on your personality, you can easily fool him by charging him 100 rupees extra. He will not mind. He will never calculate it. He will just buy thousands of rupees of stuff and just go. But remember, if he finds out, no, he will come and beat you out. Because that is what his personality is. He's very expressive as well. Whereas the small handwriting person will not do that. He will just come quietly and say, "Kya re, aapse gadbad ho chuka itna." So he will miss out the details. He doesn't have attention to the details. He will always be a result-oriented person. Next question is, standard or of organized writing will be different for both? No. Organized handwriting means what? Organized handwriting means you having the consistency. That's it. The more consistent are you in your writing, it means more organized are you. You see all those people who are toppers, who were toppers in the school, who used to manage their books and this and that very well, their handwriting was organized. The people who can manage their timetable very well, their handwriting is organized, consistent. The person who is not able to manage his timetable, who is always messy in terms of managing their time, their handwriting is not consistent. They will have a lot of variable handwriting size, variable handwriting all the time. So if you want to hire somebody in your organization in HR, wherein you need to manage the timetable and schedule of entire organization for entire year, this is the kind of handwriting you should look for. A clean and tidy person in the handwriting, consistent handwriting size. it will help you. It will help you to have a good planning in the organization. Because these people are organized. Now, let's talk about the zones. Now, this is the man I'm drawing over here again. And I'm a great artist, so you just have to appreciate the way I'm drawing it. Okay. Now, as we discussed, this is upper zone. And this is the middle zone. So upper zone is about the communication. Upper zone is about the ideas, vision, intelligence, dream. And the middle zone is about the communication, presentation, eating, day-to-day living, enjoyment, all those things are in the middle zone. So if you want to hire employees which are intelligent, who are intelligent basically, then you need to look for the zones. Now this is the upper zone. This particular zone is upper zone. So if your employee have a good upper zone, it means this person is intelligent. When I say intelligent, this person will have multiple ways of solving the problem. This person will have ability to understand different aspects of the life, of the project and the things. So if your project requires the person with great intelligence, then see, this is, now this particular handwriting has this upper zone. Now this is upper zone. Okay. This zone, something which is going beyond the middle zone is called as the upper zone. So if your employee has this kind of upper zone, it means that this person is intelligent. So if you are, if at all you want somebody to have intelligence to do some kind of work, then you need to hire this kind of people. And if you don't want anyone to have this kind of intelligence, if you want that person just to follow your orders and not to question the authority, not to question anything, and just follow the orders, then you can have a person who write this kind of H. So this kind of H, a person will be just an employee. He will not think much. He will just follow your orders. But if you are this kind of H, then this person might leave you if you are not satisfying his thirst of knowledge, the thirst of different, he will always be into knowledge. He wants to have knowledge. He wants to gain information and knowledge. So he will just do not abide your command, but he will always want to go in detail and learn about what exactly it is. Okay. So with this, we have covered the topics wherein you know, more than five we have called already. So if you have any questions, let me know right now. So LBH, basically, let me also, L, small L, small B, and small H indicates the intelligence, because these things have the upper zone. Yeah, so lower zone, J, G, and Y. J, G, and Y. J, G, and Y will show about lower zone. Now, lower zone is good for the employees who are supposed to travel and do their work. If you are hiring somebody for maybe for marketing, then this is what you should look go for. No, good lower zone, because these people like to travel. These people will not be fed up of travel. Unko ghumna firna bahut pasand hai. So the lower zone people will always are always good for the traveling or marketing kind of job. A job which requires a lot of travel. Yeah, any questions? Okay, one second. What about creatives? Can you be more specific? What about creatives is what? You can unmute and ask, no, if at all it's difficult to explain. Oh, to hire for creative department. oh, this is a big, big risk, big, big challenge, you know, because the moment somebody is creative, it means he doesn't abide by the rules. He will not follow the rules and regulation. The more the person is creative, more the person is moody, more the person will not like to follow the rules and regulation of anything. That is what creativity means. If you are following rules all the time, it means you are not creative enough. So, yeah, this is a challenge. Sorry, I can't help in this. Creative people are dangerous people. Creative people are the people who are moody, will not listen to you, will leave you any moment if they are really creative person. If you watch old movies, you know, the heroes used to be very, very moody. You know, they used to come on the set very late. They, you know, all moodiness. But if you go and watch their acting, wow, without being trained by professional people, they are awesome actors. Whereas in today's world, people are so much abiding by the rules. You know, that's why everybody has a six pack. As a hero, everybody will have a six pack. Everyone will go and join the gym, dance class, this and that. And they follow a strict routine, strict pattern. So you don't see much of a creativity. Whereas you see the repetedness of the action or the emotions. That's why if you see Amitabh Bachchan acting, you say, wow, the way he acts. Whereas if you see other actors, they are very, very methodical, you know, similar kind of thing. Lot of actors of today have somebody teaching them how to act these scenes. They don't have their own improvisation. They just do what somebody shows them. Okay, this is the way you are supposed to do it. Whereas the actors of previous generation, they used to think how I can do it. Nobody showed them that this is how you are supposed to do. But now with this kind of rules, the movies are getting completed within 2 to 3 months because they are mechanical people. They are people who follow the rules. Whereas the creative people, no. Sorry. You can't. If more the creative person is, more it is difficult for you to handle it. They will never follow your discipline. They will always want to have something new. Even if you give them good salary, if they get bored of the work, if you give them repeated work, they will leave you. They want challenge. They don't care about money. They care about emotions, expression of emotions.
Okay, sir. I have the. Shall I ask one question?
Yes,
a little bit funny question. When we have to recruit the person at a lower level, okay, then he has to go into the more detail and all these things because he is presenting that to the seniors.
Correct.
And the senior, they have to execute the thing. But what is happening when you are taking this guy initially, after some time he becomes a general manager. So his small handwriting becomes big handwriting.
No. Thank you for asking me this question. Very nice. What happens, no? The entry is the same. You know, to entry to this world is with the small sperm. So when you enter, you will always be a sperm in your organization or in the world. But the sperm has the mindset. And the only that sperm who has a mindset to become big in the world will achieve a lot. So in your organization, the person who has a handwriting of a leader, handwriting of a person who is having big mindset, only that person will get promoted. A small handwriting person, if he doesn't have this kind of handwriting of this kind of mindset of big, thinking big, taking big initiative, that person will never get the promotion. You just check. I have been with a lot of people who have been very, very successful in terms of job, in terms of business. All of them have big handwriting by default. Because big handwriting means this person will take big initiatives, big things, big work. So the only person who has that kind of mindset gets the promotion. You see, there are thousands of people who are joining the organization at that lower level, but only few of them go up is because of their mindset. Yeah, and this is the study of subconscious mind. Handwriting is a study of subconscious mind. How, there is a question that what if people who knows calligraphy, they use upper and lower zone very nicely and specifically. Again, the people who do a calligraphy are the people who are artists kind of person, very moody, And the, if you go and check the calligraphers, no, they have lot of troubles in their life, lot of challenges in their life. You just go and check all the best of the calligraphers. They do not have best of the life because of their moodiness, because of their, you know, this artisticness. They are artistic by nature, so they have a lot of issues in their life. All painters, all, you know, all these people who sketch, not a good life. A lot of challenging life they will have all the time. Something or other will keep on happening in their life because of the non-consistency of the thought. And which is at times a good thing as well. If you are into that field where, if you are focused, see, you see a lot of these artists are not getting married. So if they are not married, no, they will be very focused about their work and they will be settled. But if they get into marriage, then the marriage will have a lot of problems because the other person, the spouse, finds it difficult to adjust with this person, with this personality. Constantly in mood swings, constantly moody. It's difficult for a spouse to be good with them. So you see actors also getting divorces, singers, actors, painters, because of that. The more good the person is, more difficult it is for other people to be with him. Yeah. Responsibility curbs the creative flow. Nehasi, yes. Any more questions? So I have tried to just touch the topics. Even if I talk about the size, it has various sizes. Like, you know, there is something called as extra small handwriting, miniature legible, miniature legible handwriting, extra large, large handwriting, large medium, small medium. So there is a lot of, you know, a lot of detailing is there. We are not going to details because it's difficult to teach it in, because one topic will take around 2-3 hours to teach. So with the time, people are typing more. Oh yeah, this is a very nice question. Thank you, Sudhanshu, for asking this. So the question is, with the time, people are more friendly to laptops, computers, rather than writing. So what is happening is, you know, the more writing is a committing. Writing, when you write, what happens? You apply some pressure. So your writing is not a two-dimensional thing. It's a three-dimensional thing. Why? Because of the pressure that page goes in and it creates the third dimension. Now what happens when you don't write much? When you don't write, it's like you are not committing. Because the writing is committing. When you do a signature, it's you are committing to that thing. So the more and more you guys are not used to writing, the more and more you will be afraid of committing. That is why all these software professional people are afraid of committing. That is why they get into the relationship of, you know, that living relationship, and they don't go into marriage because marriage means commitment. So, and that is why a lot of their marriages are also failing because they are not committing enough. It is advisable for all of you to write at least 4 to 5 lines every single time, every single day. You need to write 4 to 5 lines so that you have that tendency of committing, tendency of expressing, tendency of writing. This is a very good question. Thank you. Can changing the writing change the personality? Okay, so this is a very, very tricky question. What is the problem? If you are trying to change your writing, you are only conscious about yourself when you are writing. So what about the rest of the day? After that 5 minutes, when you practice for some one particular handwriting, good. You become a good person. It's like I come to your house for the first time. You are so nice. You are so loving. But if I ask a similar question to your husband or wife, is he the same person with you every single day? No, he's different, right? It's difficult for spouse. When you are with that person for 24/7, you are a different person because that is where your true personality comes out. So when you are practicing a handwriting change, until and unless it becomes a part of your subconscious mind, your personality is not changed. You may feel good because you will write with conscious efforts in a good way, but it will not justify your behavior outside. You know, the behavior and your handwriting will always be different till the handwriting becomes part of your subconscious mind. So it takes time. You know, at times, for me, it took around me 3 to 4 years to change my handwriting in a way that it benefited me. You know, it changed my personality entirely. Okay, this is another good question. How to identify a superhero looking to signature? This is, again, it depends on a lot of aspect. You cannot treat your signature and your handwriting different. Your signature and handwriting are, it's like, you know, two sides of the one coin. So you cannot just treat handwriting and you cannot just treat the signature. When you are giving a judgment on anybody's mindset, when you are going to analyze anybody's character, it has to be both. Your signature and handwriting combined will tell you that whether this person is superhero. So the easiest way to know the superhero, see, there are multiple ways. This is one way. So one way of you knowing, okay, this person is a superhero is the ability of that person to take action, ability of that person to take the leadership or initiative. If a person is able to take initiative and then able to put action, this person is superhero. Lot of you are not able to rise to the supreme power in your life. Lot of you are not able to grow to the best level of your life is because you lack ability to take massive action. So the person who takes initiative, this is a big handwriting size, big signature, and a person who can take massive action is the person you can call it as superhero. So there is a superhero in every single person. But this superhero needs to take a lot of action to become a superhero. It's like every coal is a diamond, but he will have to endure that pressure, this, that, you know, to become a diamond. Yes. Yes, so in country, if you change lifestyle, will the handwriting? Yeah, it changes. If you see your own handwriting in before 6-7 years, 10 years, 12 years, it has changed a lot. Your signature has changed a lot. You have become a different person. As you grow, you like other people, you know, other people's habit. You learn new things. So all those things will impact your personality and slowly, slowly, your handwriting will change. Without you knowing, it keeps on changing. Here and there, it will keep on changing. Okay. Thank you very much. I'm going to see. So this question has come. If you can say something about the HR Milestone logo. So can someone share the screen with the logo so that I can analyze it? Share the screen with the logo so I will analyze it. I will help you to understand how the logo is, what it shows, and what kind of person the logo is attracting. Great. Now everyone can see this logo, HR Milestone logo. Okay, I will. So you, all of you, other people, how you know it. I'm just going to make you aware. Now, if you see this HR logo, the first thing which you observe is the height of H and R. Now, what does this height of H and R indicates? As we spoke, this height will indicate these people getting into big, big initiatives, big, big things. So these people do not think small. They want to go big. Somebody has to say yes to the analysis. If it is correct, then I will go forward. Okay. So these people will always think about big, big things. Yeah, great. So second, if you see this H, it is extra taller, you know, compared to the other edge. If you go for the same font, this font has been stretched a bit towards the upper zone. So most of the people who are joining this organization, who are joining this initiative, will be intelligent, and they always want to talk about intelligence. They will always want to talk about the intelligent things. So these are the people who are very curious about new knowledge, new things, new. So this upper zone tendency of this particular logo will always talk about the tendency of the people to join this organization for the knowledge, stay in the organization for knowledge, and this organization will always be knowledge oriented, knowledge seeking. Okay. Now, when you stress something like this towards the upper zone, automatically the H becomes squeezed and R becomes squeezed. So this squeezing of H and R will indicate these people being uncomfortable. You know, these people will always, these people will not stick to the one plan for longer time. These people will always keep on changing the plan, keep on, you know, varying your plan a bit. Kuch na kuch naya karte, kuch alag karte, kuch wo hamesha hi inke organization mein, inki initiatives mein hote rahega. They cannot be focused at one particular thing for longer time. They will keep on shifting their focus here and there, all the time. Then another thing this logo indicates is like, these people are, failing to tap the bigger personalities in this field in terms of the power. In terms of the reach, they are excellent. Excellent. They will reach to thousands and hundreds of the people. But in terms of the quality, in terms of the, you know, uniqueness, these people will have very few number of people having that kind of tendency. A lot of average and normal people will join this organization a lot compared to the unique or authoritative people. Nothing bad or good. Huh? This is what it is. Okay. And then this organization will have a bit of dominating character towards the people. Thoda sa domination rahega, thoda sa khud ki baat manmani ki tendency rahegi. And thought ko zyada mahatv diya jayega, aur thought ko hi zyada, these people will want their thought to be accepted more and more, you know. So everybody will try to push their thoughts in this organization. Everybody will try to say ki, okay, this is what I'm thinking and this is what I think is correct. And he will keep on pushing that thought again and again, again and again, again and again and again. And the best part about this organization, let me tell you the best. The best part about this organization, that people who are joining this organization are high achievers in their own life. Most of the time, whatever the circumstances was, they did the best, the best in the sense, jo bhi scenario tha, jo bhi circumstances tha, usme jo sabse achha ho sakta tha, wo kiya hai, logo ne. Yahan pe bhi, the way your organization is functioning, it's like you are giving the best of you to the community, to the world, to the organization. So a lot of you, in spite of your own challenges in your life, you guys have given the best to the world. Yeah. Can anyone of you express, since you have joined this organization, it means that somewhere your mindset is aligned with this. That's why I'm speaking this way.
So when we made this logo, we have never thought of whatever you have just narrated. But if we consider for last 10 years, if we go and reflect upon most of the things what you have said, everything what you have said is more or less correct. When we have designed this logo, the whole focus was on H only, because focus was not creating something what you have said, but only focusing the H factor, that is human factor. That's why all emphasis is given on H. But whatever you have said today, yeah, I do agree 100%.
Yeah, thank you. 10 years is a big time. Awesome. Congratulations for completing 10 years. Very nice.
Thank you. Thanks.
Great.
So anyone else can say who is associated with this group?
One more quality I will
add. Can we redesign this logo as per guidance of Mr. Sudhir Kale? Can we redesign?
Ashokji, Sudhir ji, bahut clear bola. People are very adamant. So let us think upon that. Okay. We'll take help of Sudhir again.
One more quality I would like to add. I missed out on that. So it's like all the people who are joining your organization are loving in nature. Are very, very loving. They, after some time, even if they push their ideas, they will come back and say, sorry, usme main thoda zyada bol gaya. Or adjust karlo, next time I care karunga. In that way, they will always be giving the importance to the other's emotions, other feelings.
Very right.
I'm one of the latest, newest entrants into this family, and I completely vouch by the last thing that you said. Wow. Because a lot of the ideas I see are taken, and there's a very democratic approach towards everything.
Yeah, democratic.
I completely agree with what you say. It's like a family. It's not like a networking forum at all. It's actually the love flows right across. So when you said loving in nature, I completely agree.
Yeah, very human. Absolutely. They will come to your house to help you out.
Absolutely.
That kind of mindset.
Very well said. Yeah. That's relevant to the H factor. I love that, Neha.
Yes, yes.
Sir, can you suggest any correction in this logo so that it will remove all the lacunas and it will give good results?
So
I think this is a very ideal logo, and whatever he has said, it is completely fitting to our logo. There is no a position wise everybody accepting the thought. So this is though it has without keeping anything in the mind, this has been developed. But it is a quite ideal logo. This is what I personally feel.
No, what Sudhir sir suggesting? Just I want.
But
to
know. as he mentioned that handwriting changes when you grow. So I think let it happen. The change will happen on automatically, whatever is required.
Yeah. It's like what happens. It's not because of the logo you are like this, or because of your logo you are like this. It's just
exactly.
The moment the symbol is created, automatically things will be like that in your organization.
Exactly.
Automatically influence. So we have been able to influence these changes in other organizations. Because it's a very, very powerful statement. Now, this is a statement of yours to the universe that this is what we are. This is how we want to grow. Or this is what we will be. So automatically the people who will join your organization will be like this. For example, in recent times, Wipro has changed their logo. Are you aware, guys? Wipro has changed their logo. So now if you observe, they have given the dots across that logo. Wipro now have dots. So dot means a single person, a one thought. And that now the dots are not connected. So now what kind of culture the Wipro will have? The Wipro will suggest the culture of isolation. So the moment you are a Wipro employee, you will not talk much with other people. You will not communicate with a lot of people. And you will be in, isolation, silos, You will be like, I'm not communicating enough with other people. You will be in your own world. So this is the kind of things have started already happening in the organization of Wipro. If you, any one of you know Wipro people or you work with the Wipro, you will come to know what I'm talking about. So this logo change will always impact the entire organization.
Sir, there was one thing about the logo. This is Aditi. Somehow my video is off. I'm unable to switch it on.
Okay.
So we hear in our group, we also emphasize on the fact that designations are not to be spoken when we speak of introduction. So designation is something that we don't talk of. It's only people. Like, okay, we are into HR and we talk about what is stories you want to talk or the sessions or what. So does that reflect somewhere in the logo? Is that visible? We treat everyone equal at par. It has got nothing to do with your experience. If you're 20 years of experience, 2 years of experience, everyone is treated at par. That was one thing in our organization.
Yeah, that is a human. Human in the sense, I will treat other person as a human instead of anything else. A dog is not a dog for you. It's not an animal for you. It's another living organism, another living species for whom which you should have love, in that way. You're treating everybody as equal. Human. No up and no downs. It's a human. One human to another human being.
Exactly.
That can be extended to animal as well and plants as well. A lot of you will care for plants. A lot of you will care for animals as well. Dog is not an animal for you. Dog is another human being for you. Am I right or wrong? The people who have been with this organization for a longer time. Yeah, Aditi.
Absolutely.
Am I? Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
That is what your logo is.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. That was a wonderful
thank you. So, Aditi, can you take it forward now?
Yes, sir. Surely. Thank you.
Before Sudhir can announce his gift. So you
sure,
just complete that formality first, and then we'll again listen to sir. Sudhir.
So Sudhir sir, before I summarize the whole session, one last question to you about handwriting. So should we change our handwriting to fit into the career or the profession that we want to be into? Or we should identify the handwriting that comes naturally to us and then identify the career that suits the handwriting? What should be the approach?
Okay. So it's like you need to find the passion, you know, and do whatever it takes to fulfill that dream of yours in that passion. In other words, it's not about the way your handwriting is already. Whatever is your handwriting, you know, whatever the drawbacks, whatever the challenges you have in your handwriting, keep it aside. Define what you want in your life. What is your goal? What is your passion? What do you want to achieve? And ask this question to yourself: are you willing to give your everything to achieve that dream of yours? If the answer is yes, then change the handwriting as per the requirement and become that person, become that personality, become the person who can achieve that goal.
Thanks. Thank you so much. That was really helpful. So summarizing, so it was really gripping. I mean, all of us were really there sitting through the screen. The way we started, the zero and the ones, and the zero being the mother side and the one being the father side, and how the grooming of a child should be done between 1 to 7 and then 7 to 14 and how it affects the child's youth and the life ahead. And specifically when you connected 0 and 1 to the coding, the software coding. So that was really amazing. I mean, 0, 1, we always thought 0, 1 as 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0 and 0, 1, 1. So that was how we know about coding. But this mother and father thing clubbed with the software coding was really amazing. And in one single page, the left and the right side of the page, the top and the bottom of the page can help us understand how to take an employee, how to understand what is this person about, that can help us even plan the whole manpower planning of a company, it seems, from that, you know, one single page that a person's right. So that was really amazing, sir. I would not take much of a time, and all of us are we can't wait for your gift. So I would just put these brief points in front of everyone and just hand it over to you, sir.
Thank you. So the gift for all of you is one, my small course. It's known as the drawing analysis. Okay. So what is the drawing analysis? Drawing analysis is again about how to analyze symbols. So we generally ask you to draw 6 things like sun, mountain, river, tree, house, and human being. And then we come to know what kind of mindset the person has for the growth, for the challenges, for the money, for the relationship, or for the security and all. So this particular course, I'm offering you all at free. So I will be sharing a link to Hareshji. And in that link, if you click, this course will be free for all of you. It's online course. So all of you can come and learn it. Okay, so that course will have this discount coupon attached to it, that link, which I'm going to share with the Hareshji. Within 10 minutes, it will be on your mobile in your group. So just click on it. And how many members are there in your HR family?
So we have on group, WhatsApp group, we have about around 1,250.
1,200.
And right now, this video is viewed on Facebook Live by 1,695 people.
Wow, this is such a great. Thank you. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to keep that count as 1,300. Okay, because you are 1,250 people. So 1,300 people, if they click on that link, they will access that course absolutely at free of cost. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you, Sudhirji. Thank you very much.
Thank you for giving me
this. In short time, 2 hours. I don't know how HR professionals sitting for 2 hours listening to such a nice topic. And it was very wonderful. Thank you. But yeah, it's just a tip of the iceberg. Because a lot of things I know graphology bit about, so I know how depth graphology is and how X-ray graphology can do to a person. So thank you very much, and we'll keep connected. And thank you for your gift. Let's people enjoy this gift and get better advantage out of that. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Sir, can we get your contact number?
Thank you.
Is there with you can search for my name.
Facebook चालू करेंगे तो आपको सुधीर कोवी दिखाई देंगे और कोई नहीं दिखेगा. If you start Facebook, you will find Sudhir Kovi everywhere.
So
I will share the link and the email address.
Yeah, even the course which you are going to access, no, it's on my portal, no. So automatically you will get all the details.
Yeah. Okay. So thank you, everyone. Thank you, Sudhir.
Thank you.
We enjoyed. Huh?
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Jay Prakash ji. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So can I take a leave now?